Last night's presidential debate, Donald Trump repeatedly called Hillary Clinton a liar and the devil, and said Clinton has tremendous hate in her heart. Clinton said Trump's vulgar comments about women reveal exactly who he is and show he's unsuitable to be president. But it ended on an unexpected note when the candidates were asked what they respect about each other.
I respect his children. His children are incredibly able and devoted, and I think that says a lot about Donald.
She does fight hard, and she doesn't quit, and she doesn't give up, and I consider that to be a very good trait.
Despite those complimentary comments, some people who watched the debate were so disgusted they said they wouldn't vote. The Moscow government is downplaying U.S. claims that it has been hacking U.S. political sites and email accounts to try to interfere with the election. Russian officials dismissed the hacking allegations as some kind of nonsense. The White House declined to say whether the hacking would trigger sanctions against Russia, adding that the U.S. will respond at a time and place of our choosing. Helicopters are ferrying in food and medicine to devastated southwestern Haiti. Almost a week after Hurricane Matthew's assault, there's still no electricity, and water and food are scarce. Samsung's crisis with its Galaxy Note 7 smartphone hit a new low today as the company confirmed it has made changes to its production of the problem phones to ensure safety. The move follows multiple reports that even the newly released Galaxy Note 7 phones, which had been offered as replacements for the recalled fire-prone phones, also overheated or caught fire. And no surprise here, during last night's contentious and bitter presidential debate, Facebook users and tweeters took to social media in massive numbers to share their reactions. More than 17 million debate-related tweets were sent. Users from both platforms engaged the most when Donald Trump dismissed his running mate Mike Pence over policy in Syria. The other most discussed moments were Trump's moment of chivalry, in which he insisted Clinton answered the question first because he's a gentleman. The other was when Trump told Clinton that if he were in charge of the law, she'd be in jail.
Memorable moments from last night's debate, that's for sure. Thank you, Jen. It is 6 minutes now in front of the hour on This Morning, America's First News.
Meet the new John Deere Gator XUV 590i. With over 1,000 ways to customize yours, it's like having 1,000 different gators to take on anything outdoors. Visit your local John Deere dealer to see how. Go strong. Go Gator.
Visit Room Equipment in Lowell. Or for more information, visit myjohndeeredealer.com.